is. Y'all soon gonna know what it is. Hip Rock Authority, Magic 2010, February. We are here, man. Mandalay Bay is one of the craziest years ever, and it's all about HipRockAuthority.com for the website. Get your order on. It's crazy. It's the CEO, Castle Connect. Let's talk about the line. What's going on, brother?
What's going on, man? Nice to see you again, brother.
Y'all know what it is. You know how we do.
DJ Kimball in the building. You know what it is, man.
Wow, let's talk about the booth. Let's talk about the line. What's going on, man?
Let's talk about the booth, man. What, you know, Hip Rock Authority was a concept that some colleagues of mine and I had came up with maybe about a year and a half or 2 years ago. It was just a dream, it was a vision. It was about when we were younger, being fresh, the whole hip-hop movement when it started. It was about just getting your swag on, being seen. And we actually were able to bring it to the public maybe about 6-7 months ago. We've been operating, doing business, man. But I gotta tell you, the line's doing great, man. In 7 months, we made it here to the Magic. Like, that's quick. We ain't playing, that's quick. Like, we're here. Like, we are in Las Vegas. We are at the Mandalay Bay Convention Center. We are open for business. We have been doing some great business this weekend. Like, it's just been a phenomenal response to the line. Phenomenal.
So the whole concept is retro 80s, hip-hop, rock, mixed.
It's retro, but it touches on many different sensibilities. Like, when I was younger, there was no separation between rock and roll and hip-hop. If you were on the scene in New York, you were gonna hear a Tears for Fears song. Right after you heard Tears for Fears, you were gonna hear some Run DMC. Right after you heard some Run DMC, you were gonna hear some Madonna. Right after you heard Madonna, you were gonna hear some Prince. You were gonna go back to hear some Big Daddy Kane.
Some Blondie.
Yeah, you were gonna hear some Blondie. There was no separation of the genres. Radio stations started saying, okay, well, we're gonna program, this is gonna be a black station, this is gonna be a white station. That's not what this is about. This is about hip-hop and rock and roll marrying. It's the perfect marriage of these two genres. It's like, if you like rock and roll, you're gonna like this clothing. If you like hip-hop, you're gonna like this clothing. If you like classical music, you're gonna like this clothing. I feel our line appeals to a couple of different sensibilities.
So you got... The track jacket is crazy.
Right. You know, let's talk about this for a minute. This track jacket was inspired, you know. Back in the 80s, we didn't have our own lines, so we represented others' lines that looked sensible to us. So this hip hop track jacket, I was inspired through the Fila track jackets of way back when, through the Adidas jackets. Those are my inspiration. Those helped me come up with this concept. I took a classic jacket and put a new twist on it. Like, what I did was, I took the metallic thread, as well as the metallic nylon, and just smashed it together to bring that old track jacket feel. You have the white nylon, and it all just comes together, man. It's like that being new again. We put a new twist on it.
And the kids' tees? The kids' tees.
You know, kids want to be fresh too. Like back then, when hip hop first started, youth was the movement. You know, how could I leave youth out of the line? That's the future. They're gonna keep it going and keep being stylish and fresh long after me and you are gone. That's the future right there. We gotta dress the kids. We gotta keep the kids fresh. Hip Rock loves the kids, man.
That's what's up, man. So I see a lot of people wearing it throughout the Magic and all the YouTubes, Hip Rock Authority. That's all, you know, obviously you guys are watching it right now. You know what I'm saying? You can see more. A lot of people, I'm talking about, like, from the top A-list to even the B-list, you know what I'm saying? You're doing your thing, but it's definitely an A-list clothing line, you know? It is a top-notch thing, something new, you know what I'm saying? You got Fendi, you got, you know, Louis Vuitton, you got Gucci, you got Hip Hop, you know what I'm saying?
Let's talk about what you got going on with this incident. Radio's been going crazy. I tune in every week, and it's like, I want people to know what's going on, because that's actually one of my favorite shows that I'm listening to right now. You're playing all the year.
Well, Hoodzon is here. He's the official Block News Live filmer. I'm here. You know, we brothers, we doing our thing here in the Magic. You know what I'm saying? Got my man T here. He's representing to Hip Rock Authority.
Yes, sir.
The show is hot, man. The show is just like the clothing line.
Let's talk about the day and time. What day and time you on?
Well, we on every Thursday, 7 to 10 p.m. Pacific, 10 to 1 a.m. Eastern. And for sure, man, on the YouTube. So as a matter of fact, the next YouTube, aside of the Magic Trade Show, we're going to have a Hip Rock Authority party in the radio station. That's what I'm saying. So it's going to be crazy. Y'all know how we get down already on Block News Live. You know what I'm saying? We're going to have everybody in the Magic wearing it. As you see different YouTubes coming up, different clips, different things. What else is coming up aside of, I saw the pre-floor stuff, the scarves. It wasn't able to make it. There was a shipment that got lost in the mail that didn't make Magic.
Haters, man, trying to stop the practice.
We got the scarves.
Just to talk a little bit, like, our next winter season, we're going to have some incredible scarves. wool mixed with silk. We're gonna have the ski caps, we're gonna have Scullies. I mean, Hip Rap is gonna be a brand that you wear every season. You wear it summer, spring, winter, fall. You wanna be in some Hip Rap. Check my fresh, respect my authority. Hip Rap Authority, you already know what it is.